Next year, bands, we had, what was it? It was initially a Pharaoh, Puppet Master, Valkyrie, Soul Stealer, Riftwalker, and Vindicator coming out there. So, yeah, some counter options. You know, Riftwalker, especially, not only because Root of Z, but that on top of the Flux. You never really want to let them have that combo. So, we did see Crackcase Flux earlier against Reason do very, very, very well. That was also a team that had Moira on it, I'm just saying.
I think Moira could work against him, and because he's playing against a Magmas, put simply. Obviously, he's going to have a terrible laning phase because he's going to be going against a Parasite, but against a Magmas, I think, honestly, Moira is one of the better counters because a Magmas, like, you pretty much completely counter the eruption with that one spell, because obviously it takes, you don't do damage while obviously in the Arcane Vortex. So.
Yeah.
And then obviously when you come out of it as well, it sort of buffs your own team and damages them a little bit as well, so... Yeah, I wouldn't be against it, that's for sure.
Yeah, and again, as we found out earlier, his skill set really is just strong. It's not like she needs to just be a counter pick to say Ogi or whatever. So, I mean, it's kind of funny that we're noticing because, you know, one of the other heroes that you could say is actually there's an immediate Blitz pick. Wow.
I have no idea why they... I don't know why they picked this, honestly. But, I mean, I'm all for it. I mean, I love Blitz. I was talking about it the other day. Obviously, with Nolstone picked up as well, didn't they, in... the game where I think Trent's been like 7-1 or something ridiculous as well.
Yeah.
100% win, man. It's guaranteed.
Is he really? Yeah, 4-0. How about that?
But yeah, I mean, I think it's just fusing saying, look, guys, we've got to try something new. And I mean, I think the main reason behind though why they picked up Blitz is that they want to have a good laning phase. And Blitz can offer you that with some good rotations, good early roaming in that respect. Because the reason why they won game, well, they lost game one and why they lost the other series is because I think they just wrecked in terms of the laning phase. But in this sense, they do have the Parasite, so they're not going to be probably having as many or as much impact in terms of the laning phase. But we'll have to see. Silhouette, final pick, actually.
Oh, man. We know what Flensmeister did on the Silhouette last time he picked it up.
But again, though, Tree have decent ways of countering it. Probably the best one being Dr. Repulsa. Like, can really have good ways of really countering the Silhouette. As long as Balazor has quick enough fingers, he might be able to sort of deactivate the Nullstone and then onto like a Hellflare, for example. Yeah. If he's quick enough.
What about, like, I mean, Electrician here seems like it would make a lot of sense, to be fair.
Yeah, Electrician, I guess,
still
is
use a suicide
not a bad idea.
And...
decent against, obviously, the counter from... the Silhouette. Tanky enough as well to deal with the Parasite. Yeah, I mean, I don't see why not. I don't think they play a lot of Electrician, though, is the one issue.
Yeah, that's true. But, you know, as again, as we've seen, the idea of an Electrician against a Silhouette, it's very, very, very strong.
Yeah.
So if you are worried at all about Flensmeister playing that Silhouette, then and it just so happens that, again, they need a suicide option anyway, so could make sense here. But they're going to think about it, put their time to use.
Think about that Suicide Devourer. I think they've run it before, I think, when they did like an aggressive dual lane with Glacius as well.
Yeah, so. I want to say they definitely have, but...
can be quite impactful as well with two roaming supports, so...
that's true, yeah. Blitz is definitely up there with one of the better roaming supports as well, so... That could also be a powerful pick. That would be more of a, you know, earlier game impact, of course, compared to someone like an Electrician. But they're going to basically use the full extent, it looks like... to make sure that they're ultimately really comfortable with this final pick.
I'd actually love to see Kronos. Okay, don't worry.
Kronos, that's...
the reason being is because it's the best hero against Split Push. Like, even though it got pretty heavily nerfed, obviously the 25% reduction, the hero can still be very, very good. And I think that is honestly... the hero just never picks up ever, but I think the hero is still good in the suicide lane. He's just been nerfed by quite a bit. His team fight is a little bit reduced, but... anyway, it doesn't even matter because Devourer has been picked up.
He does
up,
get TV Devo, but yeah, talk about a hero that really felt the nerf, Batman. I mean, as far as just... now, you know, nerf, whether or not it was over the top, but, you know, it's up to people to decide, but more so just how he just... he's just not seen. He went from just absolute god tier, picked every game, to just never seen. It's like...
the hero is still good, though, I think. I think people overreact, like, really overreact.
Oh, no, there's no doubt in that, yeah. that's fair, but... it's kind of interesting seeing that. But anyways, this Devo in the end, as you're pointing out. So, yeah, they got some great early game aggression. That's where Willowkeeper needs to shine here. And no doubt with the roam, especially the likes of Root of Z playing the Blitz. Yeah, Glacius, you know, Flux, even. Yeah, and hell, even their go-to carrier being the Dr. Pulse is just all across the board. This is almost like a sync lineup in it, honestly.
Oh, this is hooked from...
sight.
Is he gonna go for
this is interesting. Is he going to go for Decay instead? Yeah. Now, They had a chance to maybe go for Prisoner right there, but yeah, they got a little scared themselves. And
not worth it. They don't have Silhouette, so they don't want to take an engagement five.
Yeah.
I think they know they're going to do like an aggressive dual lane, though, and they might even try and block this or body block the hard camp. Because I don't think Sync would rotate all as five if they didn't have a kind of an interest in trying to play aggressive, but we'll have to see. I'm kind of surprised. I think the reason why Sync are running the aggressive tri lane is because they're going to try it. I think they're expecting an aggressive tri lane from Tree and they're going to try and dodge it, which it looks like is actually going to happen. Yeah, so good calls from Sync, because if Tree run on a defensive tri lane, that would dominate the sort of aggressive tri lane that Sync were going to do, because they could just block out the Parasite. But at the same time, that they blocked their own hard camp, so they must assume that Parasite might be in the enemy jungle. I don't know, this just seems a little bit like they're going half on both strategies, like half saying, oh yeah, we should go back and defend, and half going aggressive. So I don't know, a little bit of indecision here from Tree, it looks like.
See up here, yep, it's not sure exactly what they want to do, but they're going to go that 1-2-2 setup. So obviously some early rotation definitely going to be happening here. You got Engineer getting in a position early on, maybe get hugged into the trees here, but really though, Flux is one of these targets. However, it's even if you're confident with getting a good double stun off, you're probably not going to kill him just because of how tanky he is. So the idea of actually killing him here, probably not going to be the case. In fact, goes for a Kek'Sai. In fact, now taking a lot of return damage because he tanks the tower a couple times. So Engineer feeling that. He's not too worried, though.
Yeah, they're Flux, trying to bait him.
Yeah, not the, most bait, not the most burst on Flux necessarily. So he's confident he's fine, which he is. Yeah, if anything, going to go for the turn kill, but keep an eye on how that ultimately kind of plays out here. But yeah, Blitz down here at the bottom lane is going to try to get some poke into Silhouette, but Silhouette's keeping her distance, you can tell. Making sure, of course. Silhouette does have that nerfed range. It got buffed a little bit. It used to be, I think, even 350. It's now 400, but
nah, it was 400 and into 450. No, you're right. Sorry. No, yeah, you're right.
Right,
apologies. Yeah, no, you're right. Apologies. I know it was 50. I knew it was 50 increased range, but I didn't know.
I know it sounds weird though, saying 350 for a range, but it was actually 350.
No, you're right.
But yeah, now they bumped it up to 400 more recently, but still. Oh, middle lane hook gonna miss right there. Doctor able to escape, and actually Parasite is gonna head to his own jungle, so some rotations coming out here. It looks like even Engineer is gonna guard the top rune.
But Tree are doing the right thing, though. They're shutting down the Silhouette, and Silhouette it has a very, very hard time against the dual lanes because she needs the early farm, and she can get easily locked down as well if she does get aggressive dual lanes. She's not like a lot of other carries that can sort of start farming the jungle early on either, so she's just sort of resorting back to sort of pulling. So.
Yeah. Dr. Pulsar Glacius. Top lane? No, Flux is going to be fine, but going against the NG Prisoner now, so see if any big hooks come out from Prisoner again. You see the Doctor, you're always like, oh, he can get away, but yeah, no, he can't do that until level 6, so that could be a possible candidate to try to pull in here, especially if they get Parasite coming in with some kind of aggressive creep right now. He's farming away, though, with that Vagabond leader, and will probably continue to do so for at least the time being here. Top lane, poor coming in, actually, Flux. He's chasing, but not going to be enough, and actually Doctor's just going to be a rotation in the end. Doctor's just going to come top to farm, and instead Flux is going to go elsewhere, most likely all the way to the mid lane. So here's that rotation we're talking about from Tree here. You think this makes sense again?
Yeah, I think the reason being is because I think Sync realized that actually, guys, you know, we have to have at least someone trying to help the Silhouette as much as possible. Actually, they're sort of diving her a little bit, actually.
The bottom lane, yeah. Silhouette holding her ground. You see the pilfering is up as a result of slow Silhouette, but not going to be enough for any kind of kill here. He has a hook, but not really able to get the good angle for it, clearly.
Yeah. I think, yeah, Slap just rotated over because they know that, you know, they have to give Silhouette some kind of room in that respect. And that's just with him being in this jungle, he's going to have some kind of presence in the lane. Perhaps might be able to kill the Blitz if they're careful, or if he overextends like this.
Yep, there we go. There's an attempt. Oh, maybe not. I don't know where she is. She went a little too sneaky right there, as Silhouette tends to do. And actually has Parasite coming over. So the Blitzkrieg going to come out waiting for the four of the tree grapple. There's the hook. It does hit Silhouette. And a Bloodlust kill coming out in favor of Devour. However, it's not over just yet. Catman champion, the Duke. Oh, he tries to give him the burst of speed. Not going to be enough, though. And now Parasite Maven going to go for another kill. Look at the creep wave. So many creeps there. Can he actually chase him down all the way? He might be able to. Another quicken. No, not in time. The leech happens. And Slapped ends up with a double tap. So, sure, they lost Silhouette to a Bloodlust, but at least Slapped gets some nice revenge for his teammate.
I think actually Flynn's Master actually increased her GPM even after she died. I think she was like 180 before she died. She died, dropped down to 160, now she's 200. So
that's true.
Those two assists playing, they were doing good in that respect. And again, Sync having such a big impact in the laning phase. Obviously, it's only two kills ahead, but you know, it all starts that way in that respect. So.
Yeah. Top lane, possible action. Bruno up here. You got Engineer porting in. It is a 2v2 right now. Glacius and Doctor up here again. Doctor doesn't have 6 yet, so not going to be able to get away or play aggressively. Instead, they'll just counter ward. At least Engineer does. Takes out the ward of sight that was there. Get him that gold. And so no 50 gold refund to Glacius. Oh, wait. That's not till next patch. Not till next patch, in case you missed it. Anyways, bottom lane, Blitz is coming back in. And he's not going to be seen, but again, you can just see Silhouette is playing the safe game once again. He knows his GPM's not going to be that high, at least initially. Instead, his teammates will take care of the job and, you know, double tap for his lap there on Parasite. Actually, top lane, they're going to go in right here on Dr. Pulsar. Now the support is nearby. Will it be enough to hold off an actual kill on a Doctor? They get the turn kill, maybe? Yeah, they do, but it comes at a cost. Dr. Pulsar went down first. So KZU even gets credit for that. And now Engineer on the run. Quicken on a Glacius. Puts him in range for the freeze right there. Good teamwork. But it's not going to be enough. He had Pilfering, but it just wouldn't have mattered probably. So figured, screw it. Krake also gets picked off, by the way, in the middle lane. Looks like, was that to Mikke? No, Zlap getting credit. But yeah, the two of them coming together, so.
But, I mean, at the same time, obviously, they're only, like, 700 gold behind than, obviously, 2,000 experience. But one thing they still have going for him is that they are strutting down this Silhouette and they are sort of locking him down. Obviously, the other lanes are doing well, but, you know, there's still signs of hope here for Tree. And actually, this Invisible Parasite, the Baron might be in trouble. No face hug, though, on him.
Oh, he didn't go face? Oh, yeah, cool down, yeah, that makes sense. Cool down. No level 6 face hug. Anyways, puts the leech out right there, and so it's going to slow him down. But he's going to turn around with this Devour ability, and actually, is that going to buy him the time? Facelock is coming up in 4 seconds. There's a leech. He has a blood chalice to use for the facelock. There we go. Oh, he gets hooked in first by the facelock turnaround. Oh, geez. That was close to actually getting killed himself, and, well, he does die in the end, as we see right there. So Boxy at least gets credit for the counter kill. But that was kind of entertaining how it played out ultimately. But yeah, 6-3 hero kill in. As you mentioned, no, it's nothing overwhelming here by Sync Esports. And he got a Devo, despite that death, even is up there with the best of them right now, even leading the game, him neck to neck with Prisoner even. So
dual hookers.
Yeah, the hookers doing work here in game two. Devo actually invis. Okay, that's a Valdrock. So what the hell? Yeah, Valdrock as he ports in, and he's gonna try to set up right here on a Prisoner. Now, if he goes a little bit closer, he will be exposed. Did he? Oh, he landed it. I thought that was going to be off. It looked like it might have just been a little bit to the left or the right even. But
big
he got
kill,
it.
Man. He got it. Really big kill. That, I mean, Flinsmeister was sort of, Mikke was getting a little bit out of control there. Nearly like 400 GPM. And this obviously sort of secures Boxy as the top farmer as well. Now the gold lead is kind of nullified completely.
Yeah.
Of course, the experience is still ahead, but that's all because of Slapped compared to sort of, you know, they're running a jungle strat, but simply that's why they're ahead in terms of experience. So yeah, Tree, you know, I said the one weakness really is their sort of laning phase, and I have, at least for now anyway, they've sort of rectified it.
Yeah, it's a good start, and got to feel pretty comfortable again, especially out of yesterday's matches against Sync and even the first one today, but definitely turning it on again. We saw against Reason they lost that first game, remember, and then all of a sudden they turned it on in game number two, and you know, kind of, that's what they're hoping for to an extent, at least. And, you know, we also saw the power of not only Valdrot in general, but especially on a hero like Devo with that long-range initiation.
I was going to say, yeah, man, I didn't mean to cut you off, but it's good, though, because, like, the radius is only 1,000, but the hook is, like, I think 1,200, so you can kind of be invis yet still hook them kind of thing, which is really kind of a cool
1,100, yeah, just over. Okay, so, yeah, TP, so you can actually use a Valdrot while you're TPing, and that's what he's doing right here. He's going to come in. There's a discharge pull from Flux. It does get Prisoner. Well, everyone, of course, Prisoner nearby, though. Devo's going to look for kind of a hook. He gets hooked in as well. I think goes for his. No, he actually didn't use it in the end. He instead hooks in Engineer. In the meantime, Parasite goes on and there's multiple fights going on in the same area. Really, Magnus gets off the eruption. Dr. Repulsor will finish off Engineer. They already got Prisoner Code Throw. So right now it's a 2-for-2. It might be a 2-for-3. Yes, it will be. Dr. Repulsor falls. Blitz gets caught by the Magnus down. He goes down as well. You see Flux even trying to push him away, maybe disorient them a little bit, but not enough. Are we actually going to see a genocide here? Magnus, nice pushback, but it's not going to be enough. He stuns in, and down goes Flux. It is basically a genocide for Sync Esports when it's all said and done. I mean, that was such a back and forth a start right there, but yeah, long run. Sync Esports really persevered.
I think it's because, honestly, Boxy, like, he had a little bit of indecision. Like, he tried to ulti the Engineer, then Energy sort of chucked out the keg, so he has to sort of dodge the keg. I think Boxy definitely had the sort of the jump on Sync, but he just didn't really take the opening when he could. I think he could just instantly hooked onto the Engineer, bursted him down, but instead, like, he waited too long and then died himself without using his ultimate. And just sort of that little bit of indecision, Sync just really capitalized on it. Oh.
Dr. Bottom Lane, he's going to be exposed to... That was interesting. I mean, he's kind of like almost as if he's still invis that whole time. He does go in, but yeah, it's not going to clearly be enough damage. And actually, he needs to be careful himself. Because, of course, Magnus is here now. Middle lane, another fight going on. In fact, they do pick up Parasite. They're going to go for one more. Can Devo get any kind of angle here? 4 more seconds. He will have a hook. He's going to quick and apply to him. Going to land the hook, maybe. Oh, yeah, he's actually going to go for Silhouette even. Silhouette now in trouble. Beautiful turn. And down they both go, a double tap for Kraken. That was a great decision there by Boxy.
Yep.
Making sure to at least secure a second kill too.
Start criticizing him and then he starts playing and making these plays, man. But yeah, really good play. Knew exactly that your prisoner was going to be falling in. Goes for the Silhouette play as well. And really trying to lock her down is a big impact though as well. Because, I mean, she's got 300 GPM. She has actually recovered very, very well, seeing as she was against an aggressive dual lane. But getting these early kills is big, because Silhouette, like, this is the stage where she's the weakest, so if you can capitalize on when she's weak and sort of lock her down before she picks up, you know, the Nelson and Portal Key, then you'll be in a good position.
Double damage bottled up by Flux in the meantime. Again, Kraken playing that Flux. Nobody likes to do, and then it's Sanitarius. I don't see why it'd be different this game, honestly. Seems like it's just his style of play here. So some good right-click potential to be had in the near future. You got Devo, eventual portal key going to be coming, but has currently 1100 gold. He's going to use another Vile's Rot here and going to look for an attempt to kill Magnus. Now he's by himself, he won't be able to, but actually having Blitz coming in also with the Vile's Rot. So if Magnus stays anywhere close, it doesn't look like that's going to happen though. KZ a little bit too heads up there. Falls back before anything dangerous happens. You got Engineer roaming in, but he's also going to fall back before he runs into any dangers. Right there, which is also really curious because they even have some vision here. It looks like with the rune spawn, he might have just gone for it, but that's what Devo was hoping for, but obviously unsuccessful. And now regen rune instead just going to be bottled up by Mickey in the process. As he's going to head back towards the middle lane now. Continue his farm. Bottom lane, you got Devour. He's in trouble. Wild Hunter Parasite right on top of him. And he's definitely a dead man. Maybe not. Discharge push. What a play by Flux. And actually, Devo's still going to be finished off in the end. The chase is too strong there.
Yeah, I think perhaps Boxy could have maybe been fine though. Like, they had the discharge and then the blitz quickened. But Boxy, you know, was like so adamant on trying to turn that play actually. But I mean, I'd be fine with it if there was all the TPs were coming in. But Doxo had CD. Glacier didn't even have a TP, and neither did Flux. And I thought he had a potential to get out there, but clearly not.
Instead, he got top lane Magnus. He's still working on that portal key. He's almost there. 1850 gold saved up. Got a little more gold to farm before picking that up and make some plays with it, at least ideally. Astrolabe on Flux, yeah.
So I was saying it in the last series, but the last series they weren't really involved in team fights, but probably in this game they will be a lot more involved in team fights. So Astrolabe's a good choice in this respect. Top lane though, Magnus.
Yeah, Magnus, he gets caught right here. Devour and Dr. Pulsar are doing work together to take him out, so good catch on him. And actually, Magnus, that's going to delay him even more. Because I was just saying, you know, getting close to that portal key, he's now down to 1660 gold as a result of that death there. Middle lane, Prisoner, he doesn't have a portal key, might not need it. No, he misses the hook on a Flux. Parasite is coming in, though. They still want to chase this. Here comes a Valdorant, though, and more support kicking in. Flux, he's tanky. He has the Astrolabe. He already used it. He actually gets hooked back by his teammate, and the energy field trying to box him out right here, but no. Treece is going to come in and clean up house right here. Engineer also going to be picked off. Double tap for Kraki. Four are dead in total, including the Magnus kill at the top lane. And just like all of that, I mean, 14 minutes in, it's a 13-13 game. 26 hero kills already. And Devour is, well, I thought he would lead the way, but no, now Dr. Pulsar has taken over, of course, as far as leading the way. But
yeah, just good, TP rotations coming from Tree there. Like, you see that, the comparisons in bottom lane and middle lane. Like, when they had the TP rotation and they easily were able to sort of turn the tides and... Just good rotations from Tree as well. The Zinc just perhaps overextended. I think they like dive. I think the slaps came in from behind the 2-1 tower, for example. But yeah, I mean, Silhouette did take the 2-1 tower bottom, which is pretty what she should be doing because she can't take team fights until she has that Nullstone. But still good signs for Tree. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're only behind in terms of golden experience because of the Parasite in comparison to one of the supports. It's a little bit lower. And obviously the 2-1 tower was dropped bottom.
How's that? Okay, yeah, that's Devo roaming around once again, making use of the Veldrod. He's trying to get the hook. Oh, he almost got him to run back into it, actually. Some extra mind games going on. It's like, I have a feeling you're going to try to keep juking, so catch you when you juke. But no, he actually ended up not hitting him, and so Engineer, of course, fine. As he evades the hook right there in the long run. Good job by Insania. Spotting out where he was. I mean, look at just everything, the levels as well. It's definitely a little bit better for Sync overall, of course, as far as the level 11s and 10s. Five different heroes level 11 in this game, and that's the max level. Okay, Doctor hits level 12 right there as they say that, but still. Point being, very, very close, at least so far. 16 minutes in now. Overall, you see the middle, definitely some bait coming out right here. Magnus Engineer nearby. Not going to fall for it, though. Instead, Tree will, almost in a sense, set up some bait themselves. Just trying to see if what they can make happen on the Flux. Doctor does pick up a Blessed Orb, so not going to be going, you know, the Icon or just the, I don't know what I'm thinking here. But anyways, or the Hellflower. But anyways, middle lane, there's a pull in front Flux right there. Catches all three. In comes Blitz's ultimate as well. There's the hook from Devour. Pulls an Engineer. Couldn't go. Got the energy field off, but Magnus also falls. They do get the counter kill on a Blitz, but at one cost here. Parasite also going to fall. And a 3-for-1 in favor of Willow Keeper. Man, they're playing very well with this team fights.
I mean, it's just deja vu of what happened the last time. And you'd think, actually, you know, guys, just not jump on the Flux. He's got nearly 1700 HP on Strength Steam Boots plus the Astrolabe. So he's probably got an effective about 2000 HP, yet they still dive on him. And all the heroes were off the lane. They have to assume that everyone's got TPs. And as a result, man, Zeke definitely paid the price. Again, that did obviously free up enough time on the Silhouette to get the Nullstone, but definitely not worth it.
Yeah. So, as he was talking about, he has a Nullstone here. He's pushing in the bottom lane and doing it pretty well. Now, they are collapsing on him. Never mind. He has an illusion. I hate this hero. So, he's going to be fine. That is obviously the fake Silhouette right there, and they're going to find out pretty quickly as they kill it off. So, I'm going to save the secondary tower, but of course, the real Silhouette is. It's kind of funny. I'm sitting here like, I hate casting it, yet I'm sure playing against it is
a lot
worse.
Yeah.
Especially with the, you know, big tournament match here, Grand Finals after all. So, but hey, they that was just the draft decision by Sync Esports, and they picked it up, and that's the fallback thing. So that's, you know, as good as the feeling. They'll see a Willow Keeper standing strong here, and if anything on pace is actually Flux, are you actually gonna? Jeez, he was really living life on the edge right there. Not enough AoE damage between him and Blitz to take these out effectively. And he almost bit the dust because of that, but he is going to be fine in the end. As they're going to be finishing off the rest of them. But anyways, the point being, you know, again, we saw what Silhouette can do. As long as she has some okay, decent farm, the split pushing. And Flensmeister is very comfortable at it, clearly. And you even see it right there, using a little bit of that earlier on. It takes out the middle tower quickly, then ports out. And into the jungle she is, ready to continue that farm. So you just see the GPM. It just excels when she gets that Nullstone so much.
Yeah, exactly. And when she picks up the portal key as well, you probably might even see a bit more aggressive play coming from Flensmeister to try and maybe pick off the Blitz or pick off the Glaciers. She won't be able to do anything to the Varaflox or Doxer, but the squishy support she might be able to pick off, for example. But yeah, I mean, this is what I'm saying. Like, they don't really have ways of locking down this Silhouette in terms of killing her. They can deal with her split push because of Doctor, but in terms of actually killing her, I don't think they'll be able to do it, because the Null Stone is going to be able to block the Hellflower or the Sheepstick from Doctor or Pulsar. And she's going to have quick enough reactions to make sure that she doesn't get popped by the opposite charges plus the Sheepstick, for example. And that's where they won't be able to kill this Silhouette, put simply.
Yeah.
I don't see them killing her, like, outside of team fights. I mean, just in terms of, you know, catching her out, in terms of split push, unless she doesn't have an illusion, I don't think she's going to die. That's why I sort of suggest this Chronos, because Chronos can just pop the Chrono Field on her and just kill her in that way. But
That definitely makes sense. You know, Chronos, very good for the lockdown, it's safe to say. But yeah, I think that nerf, as we were talking about earlier, just... he'll be even overreacting to an extent, but it definitely was a nerf nonetheless. So they're going to go for the jump off the top lane onto Magmus. However, there's a little bit more nearby than maybe expected. But Devourer coming in off to the side guarantees the kill. And Engineer also picked off. So, you know, we mentioned it. This is going to need to be a very active game early on. And Tree has definitely made that happen. Even Sync has obviously made that happen quite a bit themselves. But it seems like overall right now it's working out to Tree's advantage here.
Exactly. I said Tree can contend as long as they get past the laning phase. It's past the laning phase breaking, and they're definitely contending. So, just obviously, you have to keep it at the back of the mind. It's Silhouette. She hasn't got, you know, she's got a lot of farming, but she actually has Thunderclaw. There it is, man.
Thunderclaw on Silhouette?
Yeah. I'm,
really? Yeah, no portal key.
Yeah. I mean, she might go portal key later. I think she just wants a farming mechanism, yeah. I believe. But at the same time...
Is Nullstone not enough?
Nah, Nullstone, I guess, is a farming mechanism, but it's more in terms of sustain, but you're not steroid farming kind of thing.
True.
Like, you pick up Rune Cleaver because you sort of steroid farm. You farm faster. Nullstone allows you to continue to farm. Like, the Rune Cleaver increases your farm, if that makes any sense.
But, yeah, absolutely.
I think she still has to pick up Portal Key, though, because the item just synergizes so perfectly with the hero. But who knows, though?
Yeah, well, like you said, I think it's a steroid farm. I assume we're going to see a Portal Key next. It is a core on Silhouette, I think it's safe to say, for how she's playing. Again, we know that Flensmeister knows how to play her very, very well at the top level. So,
we've seen before.
So, yeah, I assume that's still going to be the case. But, yeah, okay, I can't complain. I like seeing the Thunderclaw. I've always been an advocate of it, especially since the change. So, yeah, it's fun to see there. And with the GB, I mean, you already see it kind of taking place. 482 go per minute. And that's just going to continue to go up at this rate now. Doctor is keeping pace, at least, around 480 himself. Again, he went that Null Stone first, and now actually... picking up the Arcana, you know, Nullstone. There aren't a whole lot of single-target abilities here on the Legion side, so that's where it's good and bad. I mean, it will prevent things like Shackle even, which, you know, sure, I could take it off quickly, but hey, if you're preventing a Shackle as Dr. Pulsar, that's pretty good, because, as we stated earlier, that's obviously a powerful tool against him, so.
I mean, the Silhouette with the Thunderclaw, it is quite nice synergy with Silhouette as well, because obviously the Relentless Sour gives you 400 attack speed, so like your Thunderclaw procs are going to happen, you know, more frequently because of it. So it has nice synergy as well. It's something that doesn't obviously get benefited to her illusions. That's probably why we don't see it as often as we normally probably would have.
She cleaned up those ancients pretty damn quickly, man.
Yeah, man.
That was fun to watch. So yeah, again, it's a steroid farm item, as you put it, in nearly 500 gold per minute now. We'll just keep looking back, then I'm sure it'll just continue to increase here. As this game goes on, Devo going for almost like a blind hook right there. See if he can catch on a bit. He almost got Engineer, but didn't go the direction that he was hoping for, so Insania going to be fine. Mickey! Yeah, well, we talk about this a lot. Mickey, 0-4-5. Not especially in a game where they have 14 hero kills themselves as a prisoner. I mean, 0-4-5 is not usually the best stat, so... That's another reason why Tree perhaps feeling pretty good with how things are going, and actually they pick up Insania, sure enough.
Yeah. That was though just farming the jungle, and Insania walked past, and he was like, oh, I thought it was an illusion, and then Dog just started killing him, and he was like, oh, crap. So.
Not an illusion.
I don't know what that means, Breaky, unfortunately.
That
I don't
means,
speak
Ruffle, you are an illusion. No, I don't.
Really?
Know.
I was gonna say, I didn't know you speak Swedish.
No.
Oh, Glacius.
Can he actually get away? There's a freeze. Yeah, support kind of coming over. Oh. What the fuck? Mid animation! Oh my god! Is this going to be a kill though? Here comes a Blitzcrate. Yes, it will be.
God.
What a turn on a
what
freaking.
The fuck?
I don't know how you hit that hook.
I don't know even, man.
He was literally in the air.
Oh my god.
Oh, that was huge. Ridiculous.
That was a great, obviously, trade coming out from Tree. Fuser would love be loving that, honestly.
That was freaking huge. You see that? That's an illusion doctor, and so is that one, of course. So, it meant Raffle did not see you, by the way. got a
did
good
you Google
friend.
Translate that?
No, of course not. I thought about my Swedish, and I was like, oh, that's what it means, right? Come on, I've been to DreamHack like 5 times. I know Swedish. Silhouette, yeah, she points out before. So now that is a fake one, of course. Could be the real one any second. It's going to remain fake. So they deny the tower, so at least, again, kind of a good and bad. They take it away from Silhouette's farm, but they are down another tower here.
I mean, to be fair, I know this sounds ridiculous, Breaky, but like, I mean, we were saying obviously Kronos was one way to sort of deal with Silhouette, but I would actually, I would love to see Dr. Frost pick up Nullfire Blade just to kill her illusions. Like, because it obviously instantly kills illusions along with puzzle box minions, and I know it's not an item that Dr. Pulsar would go, but I guess you could perhaps get Nelflora on Devara. I'm just thinking of, you want that kind of instant initiation plus the Nelfire. Like,
I think
if you
Flux.
Get it on Flux. Yeah. No, but he doesn't have the instant initiation. If he had Portal Key, then maybe I'd agree.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
But you want the Portal Key, like, it's kind of like similar with who you want the Sheepstick on. You want the Portal Key instant Sheepstick. Same with the Portal Key instant Nelfire. But we'll have to see. I think they should get one, though, because like it completely nullifies a whole ultimate from one of the heroes. So.
Yeah, no, it's true. It really is. I mean, it's almost like the Jerizaya-esque reason.
Yeah.
You could even argue even more so, because it is her ultimate, as you pointed out. So yeah, there is legitimate argument to be made there. But yeah, it's a matter of who gets it in, and are they going to have the efficient farm to get that eventually here in the near future is a question. So
it might be Boxy, I think, perhaps.
Yeah. No, I can see that. He's going to go for the tablet here, but that's going to take a little bit of time. KZ denies the tower, as you see Devour going, and he misses the hook, though. They're trying back and forth. Dr. Pulsar goes in. There's the energy field in the back. But Engineer's going to be picked off shortly after, it looks like. Doctor is caught in him. A prisoner also. He's caught out. And he, too, will fall. A two-for-nothing exchange actually coming out from Tree, and they're going to start pushing uphill right here. Prisoner does have a buyback. He did use Prison Break, though. Granted, he could have a hook. Silhouette kind of going in, toying with him a little bit.
And that's your Conga. Conga is the safe play. I got my back off, yeah.
Yep.
They might not be able to do Conga, actually. It depends how fast they can do it. Prisoner is up in 30 seconds, but yeah, it's just a risky thing to go against a Magma Eruption plus a potential buyback from Prisoner. Are they going to rotate into Conga? No, they're playing it super safe. But yeah, again, they're still winning these team fights though. Flux, man, he's so damn tanky, put it simply, and like they have no way of really dealing with him either. And what they've done, which is quite interesting, is that they've kind of rotated Kraken on sort of the secondary carry. Like, you see Bok, he's not really farming, he's more like looking for the ganks, looking for the opportunities to make plays, while Kraken and Balthazar are just off farming. Gives them good ways to really handle Sync in the late game, because like outside of Silhouette, I mean, you know, Prisoner's okay, but he's not going to be able to contend with a 440 GPM Flux, so who knows, man?
Yeah.
I think Tree are looking very, very strong, if not perhaps winning in terms of where the stage of the game is right now.
Oh, absolutely. They are in the better spot. There is no doubt in that. Now, not a comfortable, we feel like we have the victory spot by any means, but they are in the better spot, and, you know, solid play from here on out should ultimately get them to victory, but, you know, it's easier said than done for one, and then two, again, the Silhouette factor is real. That's what I just keep looking back and see once again right there. It's continued to kind of brew here. And there you go, he ports back in, and now all of a sudden Flux in trouble. Flinsmeister plays this hero so well, man. And down goes Flux. Yeah, he's definitely one of the better players playing it nowadays. And now Glacius also going to get caught out to the side. So, and you know, right on cue, right? I'm just talking about it. Now middle lane, Boxy going to try to get out Mickey, though. Or Mickey is the one that died. Boxy does get picked up. Balthazar, however, comes in. And he cleans up Insania. That's a lot of exchanging kind of going on right there. But Silhouette, hey, she'll just freely push the top lane in the meantime. And Doctor, he ports back, so he's here now. Does Silhouette still have her illusion up? No, 9 more seconds before she can use it again. She does have a portal key, of course, though, which she uses right there. And going to be fine.
Man, this Thunderclaw is doing a lot of work, honestly.
I mean, look at she got the Firebrand and the Porygon.
I think, I mean, I play a lot of Silhouette, but I think actually I might start picking up the Thunderclaw because, like, you're seeing it now is having so much impact. Like, not only does it increase her farm by a lot, but it helps her in terms of, you know, making the ganks happen as well. Like, 150 magic damage in terms of, like, you know, helping in terms of ganks, and it will prop, you know, more than once, most likely, as well. So, yeah, man, this
definitely
opened in my eyes.
It's like a rune cleaver for range, really.
Yeah, it is. It literally is. And it's awesome, and it's working very, very well. Actually, Silhouette, though, she does have her illusion out, though, so she's going to be fun.
I was going to say, I don't know what you're talking about. That's a fake one up there, so.
She warded, like, right next to him, though. I'm pretty sure Well, she warded, but places couldn't find it, though.
Yeah.
This isn't certain range.
The real Silhouette's at the Ancients. Going to be nearly 3,000 going now. We'll pick up a Geometer's Bane here shortly and finish that up. So, once again, no doubt her farm has excelled as expected. Now, 561. Again, though, Doctor really is keeping up with her. Has the Hellflower finish, another 3,300 gold himself. And he's in a spot. Does he go Shrunken Head, do you think, here?
I think, yes. I think it's the safest play. He's going against Magmus, Engineer, and Parasite. So I think they will need Doctor. Just in terms of increases mobility in team fights, I think Shrunken might be the safest way to go. It's not as rushed or it's not as needed as some other games, but I think it's still needed here. But at the same time, I guess it depends on how comfortable he is in terms of darting around with the ludicrous speed, honestly.
Yeah.
I think either would be fine, but, like, if he doesn't do one or the other, it's not a bad play in that respect. Like, it's not like he has to go Shrunken Head. It's just one of those games where you have to feel out, so he's going to go Shrunken Head then. So, makes sense, I guess. Going against Engineer is always a good pickup.
Yeah, Engineer, I think it's kind of puts it over the top, if anything. Especially a hero that you want to be very mobile with. So, Devour, he's scouting things out. That's a true Invis rune right here. He's going to open on a Parasite. He does have support nearby. In fact, there's that support. Blitz coming in. Parasite is going to be picked up. But look at Silhouette, the right clicks. Down goes Blitz. Silhouette's going to then run away. So it ends up being a one for one, of course. Wait, Parasite lived. Oh my God, he lived.
Yeah, he
took
over
the Wild Hunter. Wow. Oh, that was a big turn for Sync right there. I didn't even realize he got into the Wild Hunter. Well played by Slap.
DD on Phlox, though. DD on Phlox, and they're taking this Congo. I don't think Sync even know. Cage is not in position,
don't.
I think. Yeah, they're going to lose this Congo.
Yeah, this
even
one aside,
after they take the...
I mean, you see again, and now they're going
to
spot it here.
They
but he has no one nearby.
Yeah, I think they might try and snatch with Slap.
Is he going to take... Oh, he gets it! Oh, he gets it! He gets the token alive. He's going to end up dying, though.
Silhouette's
unless
back
the puzzle box,
well.
There's a Hellflower, he is going to fall. There we go. Silhouette jumps in. Look at the damage again. Down goes Dr. Pulsar off the back. Glacius needs to get away, realizing that, and everyone basically. Phlox also running the other direction. They're completely split up now. Meanwhile, Magmus, he catches Glacius. Silhouette is chasing down Phlox, as tanky as he is. That physical damage cutting through him, and double tap for Flensmeister.
Jeez. That token still was massive.
Yep.
Really, really big. And, I mean, I'm really surprised, though, because Foot, like, they obviously saw him jump into the Wild Hunter. And second of all, like, they had Ward Revelation on Foot, and yet they still didn't try and make it, like, put it down. But,
yeah.
Dear.
Yeah, a big fight for Sync, and momentum that tree has had this game now. Now Sync has that, of course, and you got another 3,200 gold on Silhouette here. They get the middle tower. She's pushing bottom tower at the base. Now, Devo is in position for a hook. She doesn't have her illusion up, at least activated yet. Has the cooldown ready to go, though. Prisoner is going to be hooked in the meantime. Will it be enough for the kill? Blitz trying to finish him off. It looks like they will, but at what cost here? Energy field is down. Phlox ports into the energy field, and then a nice Kex and also push him through. But there's the pullback going for a finish. Engineer will be picked up. That's a fake Silhouette currently, because the real one's wrecking face over here, including Glacius, who actually will survive. Can she port to the fake one? Yes, she will, I believe. And
ooh,
now it's a real one. Devo! Oh, the hook just out of range. Good idea right there. But they're not able to collapse for the kill.
This is what I mean, man. Like, they have no way of dealing with Silhouette, and Flensmeister, obviously, like you said before, a great Silhouette player, and he's just not going to be able to have any impact. Like, they need an ultfire, honestly, because she's dancing around with the ultimate too much at the moment. And, I mean, Dr. Pulse isn't a natural ultfire carrier, and neither is any of the heroes on this team, but they need one to deal with Silhouette, because at the moment she's toying with them for too much.
Yeah. Oh, what's this over here? Doctor's flying in. He's looking for a kill, but if he got there a couple seconds sooner, he actually could have got Silhouette, but Silhouette just a little too quick and ends up getting away. You know, okay, so we're going to settle this once for all, according to dictionary.com. Different ways to pronounce Veiled Rot. Here we go. Here, how does it pronounce it?
Veiled.
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 Veiled. That's what I've been saying. I think I go back and forth. I might say Veiled, Veiled.
No, yeah, it's
apparently
definitely Veiled.
Apparently it's Veiled Rot. Okay, so
yeah, it's definitely Veiled, because Veiled is F.
We just really need a freaking better name for this item. That's like Veiled Rot.
You're right. Why can't I call it that purple mushroom? Like, it looks like a purple mushroom.
Just a purple mushroom, pixie dust, right. I mean. Or just dust. Let's just call it dust. Come on now.
No, I think, okay. Purple, I think we could do rot. The mushroom gank. I think that's the new term right here. It's the mushroom dust. It's the mushroom gank.
Okay, yeah, let's make that a thing. Hey, we're the ones that make it, so.
Yeah, we're the ones that make it. We're calling it the mushroom
gank. All right, there you go, settled. Flux. Look at Flux, he's like, duh, so, here, I got this. Don't worry, guys, not really. He gets Silhouette to port out him. She got she's not going to get the racks in the end, but again, she got the TPs to come in, and that's really what matters. So, if you don't have, I mean, again, Tree kind of had a lead, but a couple of things have happened here and there, including that Congor pick, the token steal and everything, and if you don't have a comfortable lead going to late game like this, it's going to be tough against Silhouette. Now, again, they pick off Engineer at least. And get the energy
One thing's for certain, that Tree, they need to keep on pushing out lanes. You do not want to give Silhouette opportunities to do that, because if he does it again, she's going to take the ranged racks most likely.
Yeah.
Obviously, racks do regen a decent rate, but still, you need to keep lanes pushed out as much as possible, because when you start Silhouette starting to split push, at least you can deal with it before it's too late, kind of thing.
Yeah.
So they need to sort of focus on split pushing as much as possible. She's got a wing, man. She's farming so well at the moment.
Yep. There's that is a fake. Is it a fake? I believe it is.
Yeah, it is.
Yes, it is. All right. The rear one's bottom lane.
Glacius is so dead.
Yeah. 3 auto attacks. She actually didn't true grapple initially, but it shouldn't matter. Yeah, there we go. Dominating streak is real for Flensmeister. 10-2-6. And now he's going to continue to push out the bottom lane. You do see Blitz right here. He's hiding nearby. Blitz has his Lightning Shackles ready to go. Lightning Shackles are a pretty strong AoE tool, honestly.
I think there's only one way to deal with Silhouette. Obviously, if they're not going Nullfire, is one way. But if they're not going Nullfire, there's only one way they can do it. And they have to have perfect, I mean, I'm talking perfect execution with Tree. And that is Blitz Portal Key onto the Blitz Tree to take off the Nullstone. And then obviously follow up with the Dr. Repulsor. Talking about Dr. Repulsor, though, top lane.
Yeah, he's in trouble. Going to pop that Shrunken Head. Do they have any way to stop it? Doesn't look like it. Oh, they almost did. Born again. Meanwhile, bottom lane, Blitz, speaking of him.
I'm surprised Silhouette's not in.
She's going to fall back, yeah, falling back before too much else happens.
But no, yeah, they need to obviously get... the one way to take off the Nullstone would be the stun from Blitz. And just when the Nullstone's taken off, Doctor needs to use a Hellflower or obviously the opposite charges. Preferably the Hellflower because it has higher range. But oh, here comes Silhouette. And
mushroom
bye-bye range
from
rats.
Doctor, but actually Illusion or Invis on... as well, but yeah, you see the range. Oh, it's going for the range tracks. Interesting there.
Yeah,
actually going to port out.
He wasn't going to get the melee. They've got too much armor.
True.
They got 10 more armor. It's the right play to make.
Might as well get something.
Yeah. And this is what I mean. They need to push out lanes, because if they push out lanes, Silhouette can't do that. Or as effectively. Obviously, she can, but it's going to be a lot harder, for example.
Yeah.
Well, Parasite might be in trouble.
Yeah, he's in that Vulture Lord, of course, so initially he's going to be fine. Yeah, it's... Or another hero that's getting some necessary nerf right there. He's gonna be feeling that next patch a little bit, nothing too crazy. But anyways, yeah, gets away, gonna be fine. Yeah, it's maybe just a little bit of a lag kick up here. Before we resume on, you mentioned that wing bow already purchased on Silhouette, another 2,600 gold just like that saved up. 662 gold per minute farm on her. And who was that against? But he's only 2-1 on the hero, so not
Dawn.
A ton of... Was it against Dawn? That's right.
Yeah, I remember. Because Dawn would dominate in the team fight, and Cleanse was literally 1v5 the whole team because of his split push.
I do remember that, yeah. Okay. So that was that game. It's not maybe as crazy here, but it's still the idea, and this is what you like to stress here with this hero. It's like, people need to pick up this hero, man, for this reason.
Yeah, I literally don't... Like, the only way you can effectively shut down Silhouette, if, obviously, if you don't have the quote-unquote counters, is take her out in the laning phase. And they try to do it, but Flensburger, again, had great recovery. Like, I don't understand, these carry players, that they get shut down in lane, yet they still full out, like, come out in, like, 10 minutes with, like, 300 GPM, which is just... I don't understand how they do it, but I mean, like, if they're getting shut down, they should be around like 200 max GPM, but it comes up with 300 and makes a big difference in terms of their recovery. So,
yeah.
And yeah, I mean, Tree, they even try to shut down Silhouette in terms of the laning phase, but they just simply didn't do it effectively because now Silhouette is now the highest farm in the game. So, but yeah. I love Silhouette, man. Just, it's such a fun hero as well. It, like, honestly, he's one of the funniest heroes.
She
because,
is? Yeah.
Yeah, it's because you have so much, like, I think the most interesting thing about it is that the skill gap is very, very high. Like, the ceiling is almost endless kind of thing. And I just love that.
Yeah.
Even though I'm not even that good with her, but I just love playing her. She's so much fun.
Exactly. She's entertaining to watch for the most part. But, again, the obvious frustrating thing, though, is, like, you can never really tell which one is the real one. But she honestly is a lot of fun to watch because of how mobile, how very active she is and constantly making things happen and with that ability. So...
I think she's probably a bit too strong at the moment. I think there should maybe be a little bit more looking at her ultimate, like 100% damage as well, or even a look at a swap as well. Like maybe like the cooldown is like 5 seconds on swap, which I think is a little bit too strong.
Well, let's maybe just say, you know, initially she had the 350 ranges we were talking about, and that got buffed up. But, you know, I think that was one of those buffs of like, okay, I mean, I guess we'll do it because still not many people are playing her, but you realize that she's very powerful. And people will kind of realize that eventually. So, and Sana gets picked off, by the way, Doctor. He's been doing plenty of that this game. But bottom lane, that's guess what, a fake one. Now, the Ruin's nearby. She might actually port in. Yeah, she's going to go in right here. She's going to try to jump Blitz. Look at the right-click damage. And Devour, no, barely left. He's locking down the correct one. And he tablets away the last second. They're going to turn it. No, he ports out. Lensmeister gets away. And again, abusing the power. Oh, and he goes, that's just ridiculous, man.
This is what I mean. Like, I mean, I've been saying this for ages, but...
Oh, my god. Mid lane, though. That freaking hero. Indeed, middle lane. Dr. Pulsar's trying to get away. No prison break. That's the stop. No, he didn't pull in time. So he gets away, but... I mean, it's just... It's ridiculous. He already regen, and now he's back running around, too.
Yeah.
Like...
But, I mean, the bad issue is that Trigg, I think they are kind of somewhat... superior perhaps in terms of team fights, but they can't take team fights because Flensmeister will just split push if they're not careful. So, oh, bottom lane slapped.
No. Going in with the Wild Hunter, yeah, trying to see if he can find any opening. Not really finding it though. Instead, falling back middle lane prisoner will get caught out. Diva with the hook and guarantees the kill there.
I mean, they're getting a lot of pickoffs, it's fine, but like. It doesn't kind of matter, but simply is that because every time they get a pickoff, they cannot turn it into any kind of objectives. Congress obviously still down, and the racks, you know, the lanes are so pushed out that they can't rotate into some any kind of like racks push, for example. And they can't sort of group up and try and force a team fight because Silhouette is doing a great job of sort of split pushing lanes. And actually, Devara might be in trouble.
Yeah, you see the Wild Hunter Parasite now. He's not coming out of the Wild Hunter. He knows that he has a. You know, good thing being in it right here.
Silhouette's taking bottom racks as well. Bottom racks,
it's just the distractions, man. That's all they're going for right now. Now, Silhouette, that's... I want to say that's a real one.
Nah,
I think that is.
Nope.
Never mind.
Because he's top.
Because he's top. I don't like this hero. I'm going to talk. There really needs to be some kind of spectator thing, at least. It plays like a big-ass arrow. Like, this is
they can kill it now, though.
That is the absolute real one. Gonna try to chase. Magmus is gonna be caught. Nope, stuns away. Not enough of a chase. Dr. Pulsar out of mana. Look at Silhouette. She goes in. She finishes off the Nethers, and she's gonna tree grapple away. Cause why the hell not? And she gets on out of there, so.
It's actually so awesome to watch, like, a really good Silhouette player as well. He's playing it perfectly, honestly. Like, there's nothing else that he can do better.
You gotta be so frustrated if you're tree, though, right? This is
Like, there's nothing they can really do outside of picking up Nullfire, but whether they have even thought about it or not, like, I don't understand, but, I mean, Shrunken Head on Vara is good, but clearly this Silhouette is being too hard to deal with, and the only way you can really have ways of dealing with it is the Nullfire Blade, outside of, obviously, you know, switching the draft, which obviously they can't do, so in terms of what the situation they're in now, they have to pick up Nullfire Blade, but, I mean, first of all, who would farm it? The only one who can really farm it is Dr. Repulsa, because... no one else is really farming effectively. and Silhouette's taken top range tracks as well. So in the meantime, they just got no way of dealing with the illusions. I mean, I mentioned these issues at the start of the draft, and I don't know where Tree thought about them or not. Obviously, they had to deal with obviously them having strong lanes, and that's where, you know, Devara came in. But I don't know, man. Oh, mid lane though.
Just feeling their frustration, man. But yeah, they're going to get a catch on a Prisoner. So again, this continues. They've been doing this pretty actively. They're getting ganks around Silhouette, but Silhouette then eventually comes in like this, and, you know, does her thing. Blitz, just one more auto attack. He actually is going to get away with the quick, and Doctor will finish off Magmus in the process, and he gets out of there before he gets caught. So it's a double tap for Palutasar. You look at, there's a Portal Key Silhouette though, and Glacius didn't stand a chance right there. Devour is still nearby, however. He has a Portal Key. He can actually lock her down right here. He's going to go for that. There's the hook. There's a lockdown. That's the real one, 100%. This is a kill. Is this actually a kill? Oh my god, it's actually a kill. 800 gold streak. There you go.
She just buys. She bought back.
And she bought back, and she's top. I think she's a fucking hero. Oh my god, she posts a
Zin. If she takes us at the end,
it's game.
Game, but I don't know,
I mean, that's game. That's Mega Creeps. That's game. Oh, jeez. I'm frustrated for Willow Keeper, man. I can feel the frustration, and it's completely understandable.
Man, that's what I'm saying.
It's just great play. No, great draft, great play by Syncta, and great play by Flensmeister. It's not easy to do.
That is, he played it absolutely. It's honestly, it's a beauty to watch because, like, I mean, I'm obviously, I love Silhouette. I'm watching him play. It's just, oh, it's a great play, honestly. Just can't say it enough. But at the same time, Breaky, like, you know, this is what happens if you allow Silhouette this kind of farm and this amount of, you know, control in the game. If you don't address him in terms of the laning phase, if you don't address him in the draft, this is what can happen. And the only people they can blame is themselves. They didn't pick up Nullfire Blade, and obviously they allowed it to happen in the draft. I mean, I've been saying it every single cast. Silhouette is an amazing hero, Breaky, yet teams just completely oversight it. And, well, in this case, Tree, they paid for it.
Well, yeah, again, remember, too, it's they had the chance to even pick up a hero like an Electrician with that final pick. Instead, they went with the Devo pick. Now, again, Devo ultimately worked out very well in the long, you know, big scheme of things. 6, 6, and 15, had some good farm all throughout. But was that worth it going over, you know, the guaranteed counter to a hero like Silhouette with the Purge? And so, sure, it's a hindsight now, but they had that opportunity. So you got to wonder if how things may have been different, but...
Yeah, and I mean, one thing that I didn't really see them do either is, like, they never used Flux Ult. You just take off the Null Stone from Silhouette either. Like, if they take off the Null Stone, instant Hellflower or Sheepstick, they had ways of dealing with it as well. But, I mean, they had somewhat the tools. Obviously, they didn't have the best heroes, perhaps, to really deal with the Split Push or the Illusions, but they still had ways of dealing with it, particularly, like, the Flux Ult into, like, Dr. Repulsor Initiation. But, I don't know, man. They've got no one else to blame but themselves.
Yeah, that's what it keeps going back to. All right, so, well, you know, here's the big picture now, what just happened right there. Of course, Sync Esports, they are your Cycle 6 champions. So after all that Silhouette talk, yes, sure enough, they are the Cycle 6 champions. They take the series 3-0. And, of course, that means Willow Keeper will finish up runner-up yet again here. So, you know, again, a solid finish, nothing to be too disappointed about ultimately. But especially with how much they've been getting, you know, even the first game today and the two games yesterday, they were getting stomped by Sync, really. They actually played very well this game, for the most part.
Yep.
And
I
it
said,
just simply was the Silhouette factor. So
I said, like, if they can get out of the laning phase without having too much of a bad impact or losing too much, they can contend. But in this game, it was just clearly the Silhouette factor was too much for them. They had a good timing as well. But, I mean, a big play came out from Slaps as well. They took the token, and that really did set Tree behind because they weren't able to push off of that. If they were able to push off of that, they could have perhaps, you know, got racks of them of their own. But, alas, Silhouette. The beauty in the night was too strong.
It was fun to watch. All right, I actually got a interview guest here. Speaking of Silhouette, we got the man who actually played the hero in that final game and get his take on maybe what he thinks about it and how that went, but also just overall. Flensmeister, are you there?
Hello, boys.
Hello. Good for you to join us here, I'm sure. Good feeling. First, I got to get out right out of the way. I mean, Silhouette, man. Silhouette. Ridiculous. Do you feel dirty playing Silhouette?
Actually, no.
No?
I don't know why everyone thinks so, but like I don't think the hero is that good. Like, it's sure it's a good TMM here, but it's not OP as everyone make it out to be.
But when you play it like you do, it seems OP. I think it's safe to say now, but
ooh, breaky. No, but like honestly, I don't think I should have that of an easy time against a doctor, because he can fly and he can just use W and then instantly health flower. So with the against the correct lineup, it's really hard to split push. I just think I had an easier time than I should have this game.
Yeah, we were talking about, I mean, they had the chance to draft like an electrician with that final pick, and he's usually pretty good against the silhouette for the purge, but yeah, they went with the Devo, you know, but hey, it ain't easy, and you made it very difficult. But overall, again, you guys take the series 3-0. How do you think that this cycle and this final, especially kind of compare, do you feel like you're the most dominant maybe you've been so far even?
No, I would say cycle 5 was the most dominant.
Yeah,
I think we have gone down a bit, but hopefully it will be even better than cycle 5 the next cycle.
Yeah. Are you almost a little disappointed that the competition maybe wasn't as, you know, strong, especially in the grand finals here? Or is that, you know, you guys seem like you're pretty comfortable, especially against Tree here.
I think there was competition. We were really close to losing this game, actually, because we dove mid a couple of times and they turn killed.
Yep.
So I wouldn't say like it's pure dominance or stomps. I think the games are pretty competitive.
Yeah. Definitely. We were talking about that, D. It seemed like Tree was actually looking very good for most of that game right there. But again, the great silhouette play at the end, especially for the last 10, 15 minutes, just made it too difficult to overcome. So, you know, here you are. So this is now your 5th cycle victory of 6 total. Of course, only 2 more cycles left. What do you think is kind of your plan? Now, we do have a little bit of a break here, first off. There is going to be, I think it's like a 3-weekend break, you know, with the holidays coming up and everything. Are you guys just going to basically, you know, take it easy for now and enjoy the holidays for what they are and eventually come back? Or you guys plan to play a little bit throughout here?
I'm pretty sure most of us are going to take a break. Like, I know Insania for sure is going to go on vacation somewhere.
Yeah.
So I think we'll just resume playing sometime after Christmas or like January. So, right. Yeah.
Look forward to that. And again, that's, yeah, I think it's like January 10th or something like that when Cycle 7 kicks off. So, you know, again, though, we don't know how the second stage is exactly going to work, you know, past the regular season. And obviously, you know, if it's similar to last season, you know, the playoffs and then the first team getting that invite. You guys are in a very comfortable spot. Do you, you know, at this point, it's safe to say you're in a pretty good spot to probably claim number one. Do you think that's going to impact your play moving forward for the end of the season, or do you guys feel like you're actually still going to give it your good effort here as far as the finish?
I know for sure I'm still going to like keep trying 100%. I'm pretty sure the rest of my team are too, but still the confidence factor that we're already qualified might affect in some way. But we're going to try at least to play 100%.
Mm-hmm. That's good to hear. Mini, you have any questions here?
Yeah. First of all, I don't know how involved you are in terms of the drafting, but you picked up obviously Parasite in game 2 quite early on in the draft compared to game 1. Was there a big reason why you picked up a jungler in game 2 and not in game 1? Or?
Well, this draft, for example, Insania was just response picking to them, and we both think that Parasite is really good against Flux. Because
what's that?
Obviously, you go Puzzle Box, and Puzzle Box is just so good against the Flux because of the burn mana.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's cool. It is. And then secondly, Thunderclaw and Silhouette, it's probably the first time I've ever seen it, but it worked fantastically. I was going on about it, and I was like, what's your reasoning? I'd just like to know, because I'm a dirty Silhouette picker as well, and I've never thought about it, but it worked very, very well, so I'd have to copy it. But
my reasoning is that normally you go Nullstone and then into PK. But unless you're super farmed already and you have a lot of kills, the PK doesn't really do anything. So I like to get Thunderclaw to just get super far ahead. Okay. And also it provides a lot of damage with the Relentless Salvo. Mm-hmm. So I like it to farm faster, push lanes faster, and just steal more damage. And we were pretty far behind this game, so I just wanted a recover item.
Yeah, dominated that game. Yeah, so well,
where you're so used to seeing the Nullstone and the Portal Key, but no, it did make sense. And yeah, we got to see the impact of it. Your GPM just skyrocketed.
I'm definitely using that. I'm stealing it.
Hey, Thunderclaw, you know.
I actually am. It's so good, though.
Thunderclaw was a great change, I thought. And, you know, we haven't seen a couple people pick it up here and there. It was more recently, so.
Yeah, even on bubbles.
Yeah, even on bubbles. couple questions, a couple more from me here. So you kind of talked about the draft a little bit there. You know, you used to be the drafter, no longer anymore. What's the deal? How has that transition been now in San Diego being the drafter? Is that everything working out there? I mean, things seems like it's going pretty well.
Yeah, actually, it was my decision or suggestion rather to put Insania as the drafter.
Okay.
Because it's really hard as a carry player to do the captaining. Because I try to look for farming patterns all the time, and if I have to captain farm 200 items on that guy, then we go push 5 top. It just takes so much off of me, so I can't really focus on my gameplay. And Insania has been a captain for a very long time, and I know he drafts really well. So it was really all of us that wanted it to happen.
Yeah.
And it's working out good. He asks me for a lot of advice, and I give whatever I think is good.
Cool. You know, it seems like safe to say, again, here you are, back-to-back cycles now that you've been the captain role for Insania, and it's obviously you've done very, very well these two cycles especially. Been fun to see there. But also, what was it? Oh, yeah, so now this is the last cycle. Like I said, you got the break coming out. But at the same time, there will be a patch coming out this Wednesday. I'm sure you've heard of it by now. Patch 3.6 is going to be coming out. There's a lot of changes. I don't know if you actually have behind-the-scenes access. I don't know if you know all these changes that are coming out. But eventually, this week you will know nonetheless. Are you looking forward to this balance patch, seeing what it's going to do? It's support focus, so you've been a carry player, but...
I don't give a crap.
No?
Support?
You're just like, whatever, I don't care.
Exactly. No, but I like a lot of the changes, so I really hope we see some new heroes. I know we should be seeing some new heroes from us, at least.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to it.
Monarch, man. Monarch and Martyr changes. How much Monarch are you going to play?
A butterfly every single game.
Is that strong? He probably will be, man. It's going to be ridiculous. Swiftblade getting nerfed, that's also good, I think. It's safe to say. Did you shed a tear when you saw that?
No, not really.
No.
Because it's not like a, what is it called, signature hero? It's a hero that everyone plays, so I don't really mind if it gets nerfed.
Okay, that's fair. All right, yeah, no, that's going to be a fun patch, and I don't even know fully everything that's coming in. I haven't even really looked it over, so. Again, that comes out Wednesday, though. Patch 3.6, guys, is going to be fun. So it's safe to say, you probably need to look up on that and practice a little bit before the next cycle. Do you kind of like that, though, with that said, how it's happening, a balance patch happening almost like a little bit later on mid-season where you got a couple cycles left in the playoffs? Do you like that, or would you prefer if it happened after everything was over?
I don't think it matters too much, honestly, because we still have two cycles and there's going to be a lot of breaks. So I think it's just fine. I don't think it matters too much for the grand finals in Thailand.
All right. Well, I think that does it for me. Unless many of you got any crucial questions here.
No, I'm just looking forward to Flensmaster carrying me in houses, as usual.
Teaching you how to play Silhouette as well, apparently.
Yeah.
So.
Yes.
Appreciate that. No, Flensmeister, always a pleasure, man. Congratulations again on the victory. And how dare you pick Silhouette? How dare you? Everyone hates you now.
Yeah, such TMM cancer.
It was a lot of fun to watch, though, man. You play that very well. So congratulations, though, and thanks for joining us.
Thanks.
And, well, any shout-outs or anything you want to say, by the way? I forgot to do that.
Shout-out to Mickey. His score was 0-9. That's really good.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure he actually has really bad win percentage with that score, because he usually carries us. But anyways, just a shout-out to all of my team. They're really cool, offline and online. And shout-out to Panny. He's a really cool dude, too.
Panny's always good.
And, yeah, that's it.
All right. Thanks again, Flensmeister. Appreciate it, man. And, again, congratulations.
Yeah. Peace.
Later. There we go. Flensmeister, the captain, of course, of Sync Esports, joining us there.
Would you call him the captain, or would you say it's
I think, yeah, no, that's fair. Okay. No longer the captain, I guess. And
sorry, I didn't mean to...
You're right. I'm just so used to calling him the captain, but technically not the captain. The carry for Sync Esports. Is he really even that, though? I mean, we've kind of joked about that, as far as carries go.
It's funny. I do, but I think I think particularly with the metagame now, we are seeing a lot more carries. So
yeah.
I think it's,
well, I,
but
yeah.
Before it was a lot of teamfight heroes like Poly or Priest or like Kraken or whatever. But
yeah. Stay Green has a Slither even or something like that.
Yeah, exactly.
But yeah, no, he carried that last game. It's very safe to say.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, Mickey 0-9-8. You know, he pointed that out too. But that's not usually, again, if Mickey struggles and overall, I mean, again, the team overall was struggling. It's because of that silhouette play that they were able.
It's a warning to all the other teams. Either you address him. It kind of seems to Oogie, though, as well. Like, you address Oogie, or he'll just take over the game. Similar to silhouette, I guess.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's going to be... You know, so that was the final game of not only the cycle, but of this patch. Mm-hmm. By the time the next cycle rolls around, it's going to be a completely new patch, man. I mean, it's going to be... There's going to be changes. There's no doubt in that. I mean, obviously, with balance changes happening like there are in the upcoming patch, there's going to be changes as far as strategy goes. And again, people are also starting to get comfortable with Veiled Rot, a.k.a. Yeah. Mushroom Gang.
Mushrooms. That's going to be a thing, but break.
Of course. Right? No, that's what we're calling it. We decided in the cast that's going to be our thing. The Mushroom Gang. It's going to be really fun to see how that all develops. And whatnot. So, you know, Flint's Bucks are kind of being pretty open there as far as, you know, again, they aren't a comfortable number one seed and, you know, maybe not going to be grinding out over these next 3 weeks, and that's understandable. It is a holiday after all, and that's why there's this longer break in the meantime. But before Cycle 7 rolls around, I think it's safe to say at least a couple of scrimmages will kick in to kind of get a feel for the new patch and what is what. But so that is going to start wrapping things up here for today. You know, I want to say too, though. So we do have a little bit of a break here. Once again, wait, what is this about? Quincy making a point. yeah, Mickey. Apparently, that's his first game in season 3. He actually did not get a hero kill. So even more insults right there. To Mickey.
See what Flensmeister said as well.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. How about that? And the keyword is Mickey feet in chat. Jesus, we are just really ripping on Mickey right now.
Oh, dear.
The dude's awesome. There's no doubt in that. Anyway, so, yeah, that's it. It'll be starting to come to a conclusion. But, again, before we ultimately wrap up here, again, we have a little bit of a break here now. So let me just confirm the date. Like I said, I believe, yeah, it's going to be January 10th is when Cycle 7 kicks off. So, obviously, that's a good 3 weekends here, basically, in between that there will not be any Hunt Tour coverage. And, again, unless something pops up, that probably means no coverage in general. But don't be surprised if at least, a show or two, you know, throughout the weeks comes on. Especially, with the big patch coming on, I think it'd be cool to kind of get some players on and kind of get their take on certain changes in the patch and whatnot like we've done before in the past. So, wouldn't be surprised if we do something like that as far as, talking about something, so I'll look at organizing that.
I'm available. My parents live. My whole family lives in Ireland, so I'm doing anything for Christmas. I'm literally gonna be sitting
here
streaming.
I said pro players.
Oh man. Damn. Okay, man.
Oh boy. No, of course you are welcome. We'll look to do something like that, and have a good time with that, and also the awards, the 2014 awards. Oh, again, yeah. Hopefully this week we should have actually that available to you, the community, as far as all the nominees for the categories, and get your chance to vote on who you think deserves what. And then by the end of the year, if not early next year, we'll have the awards announced to who is what and the congratulations given out and everything. So looking forward to all that. So just because we are on a break here as far as Hauntier coverage doesn't mean there's going to be absolutely nothing happening. There will be something. Just stay tuned to our our Facebook and Twitter here on Honkast for updates of anything. I'll let you guys know what is what. So that means we are going to be wrapping up for now, though. Again, for Haunt Tour coverage, again, congratulations to Sync Esports. Mini, as usual, any final words, any shout-outs here?
Yeah, just shout-out to my stream and my Twitter, which is both mini_maggot. I will definitely be streaming. I won't be streaming tonight, unfortunately, because I've got early work shift tomorrow. But in the next next couple of weeks, obviously, I'll be streaming, be dancing, have some cocoa, have some £1 fish. Breaky, you won't understand because you don't do my stream, but
nope.
All my followers will know about the cocoa and about the fish. So
I need to, though.
See you guys there.
So you're going to be going over there right now?
I won't be going over there.
No,
right now,
you're not. Okay.
Sorry. See, but the next couple of days / weeks.
The one night I would have tuned in, man.
I'm sorry, Breaky. I'm sorry. I've got to get up at like 7 o'clock tomorrow. No, oh, that's when I start work. Man, bloody banks.
Real life, man. Sucks. All right. It looks like Quincy's not streaming either. So, one's streaming apparently. All right. No, but there's other Holland streams out there. But if anything, again, keep updated, guys. Possibly this week, even I'll look to start getting some podcasts going and talking about the patch, because again, it's a big one, and really help hype about it and also get some ideas of what people think about it. So look forward to that. Again, stay tuned to Facebook and Twitter. So shout out to you guys for tuning in as always. Thank you for tuning in, and hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Another great cycle in the books here. Sync Esports, they are a top team right now, and it's going to be interesting to see if that ultimately changes by the time these next two cycles get played. Hey, but with some time in between it and a new patch coming out, you never know. You never know what teams may kind of step up their game going into what is cycle number 7. So, ladies and gentlemen, though, we are officially going to be wrapping up here. Shout out to Quincy as well, of course, as always. Shout out to